The new 8 o'clock on CNN. Parker Spitzer, weeknights on CNN.
After a dismal few months, President Barack Obama is ending the year on a high note. Congress pushed through a flurry of bills before the holiday recess, including Don't Ask, Don't Tell and the START Treaty.
Earlier today, the president held a press conference touting these successes and how Congress came together despite predictions of gridlock.
If there's any lesson to draw from these past few weeks, it's that we are not doomed to endless gridlock. We've shown in the wake of the November elections that we have the capacity not only to make progress, but to make progress together. And I'm not naive. I know there will be tough fights in the months ahead. But my hope heading into the new year is that we can continue to heed the message of the American people and hold to a spirit of common purpose in 2011 and beyond.
Joining us now to discuss whether the president has regained the momentum, David Gergen, former presidential advisor. Welcome, David.
Thank you.
You know, I don't believe in coincidences, David, and I know you visited the White House recently, gave them some of your wisdom. Suddenly, there's a flurry of successes. So is this all your magic? And more importantly, are you going back as chief of staff to the president in the coming year?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, come on, Elliot. You know better than both those things. And the president and his team, his current team, deserve an awful lot of credit for this. I think they played very smartly with this. I think Harry Reid was smart. It does seem to me that he's found a new way of governing. And with the end of the elections, he's no longer relying on going up to a Democratic caucus and getting Democratic victories from Nancy Pelosi and Harry Reid. Instead, what he did in each one of these three victories he got was he formed an alliance outside the Democratic caucus that really helped to bring public opinion his way and then sway votes in the Congress. On the big tax bill, he worked with Republican leadership, got it done. On Don't Ask, Don't Tell, he had Secretary Gates, who is a very influential figure in Washington these days, along with the head of the Joint Chiefs, who lined up with him. They helped to really drive home the point that Don't Ask, Don't Tell repeal was sound policy. And then on this final one, on the START treaty, this really turned around when he brought in the former Secretaries of State, Republicans, and that reversed the momentum.
So, David, you know, it takes every president a year or two to kind of come into his own and sort of figure out how to do the job, really. Do you feel like this is partly Barack Obama kind of figuring out who he is and how he wants to operate?
Well, that's an interesting insight. I think, yes, I think experience has helped him. We also know, Kathleen, as Richard Wolff, who's written a recent biography, argues that he's a clutch player. He likes coming in and scoring at the last minute, and he enjoys that. He plays for that. And, you know, some people are really good at rising to that occasion.
The distinction I would make, and I agree with you, these are very nice victories for the White House, for the president, but I think there's a fundamental distinction between Don't Ask, Don't Tell, and START, social issue and a foreign policy issue, as opposed to the fiscal related issues that are waiting for him come January, where he's going to be facing a very different and I think a more rigid Republican Party, where there will be tougher issues where there may not be as much give on either side. That I think is where the real tensions are going to emerge.
I think you're right. This is the Republicans got a big victory here too in this short tail. They stopped that omnibus spending bill, and it does set up huge showdowns over deficits on two issues. This continuing resolution they passed on the deficit runs on the budget spending, runs out in March. It means they've got to have a new bill to fund the government. And secondly, as you know, Elliot, the government's going to break through the ceiling on the national debt, and the Congress has got to vote to raise the debt ceiling. Both of those give the Republicans a lot of leverage, and I think we're going to have real showdowns February, March.
In his press conference today, President Obama was asked about the tax cuts. Let's take a quick listen.
Look, the frustration that people felt about that was frustration I shared. I've said that before, and I'll probably say it again. I don't think that over the long run we can afford a series of tax breaks for people who are doing very well and don't need it. We're doing well when Bill Clinton was in office. You know, they were still rich then, and they will still be rich if those tax cuts went away.
So, David, what's your take on that? He sounded, is he still sounding presidential there?
I thought he was. I don't know quite where he's going to go on this budget. He's going to have to look at Medicare. He's going to have to look at other things. And he's going to have to look at, frankly, at changes in taxes, which are going to put the squeeze not only on the more affluent, as I think we should, but I don't see how we get from here toward balance without increasing the cost to the middle class.